Hello once again, everyone, and welcome back to Big Monday. We continue now as we move to the Big West, and in conference, UNLV, the number one team in the nation, a perfect 8-0. Utah State at 4-4. These two teams have met 18 times in the past. All 18 times, UNLV has come away with a victory, including earlier this year. And Jim Valvano, as we welcome you back, it looks like this one could be a fight because they had a fight last year when they met, but this has the makings of Mike Tyson against Michael Jackson.
In other words, a mismatch is what you're saying. Well, let's take a look at the tail of the tape of these two people and see if, in fact, we do have a mismatch, right? We got the records in Vegas, 15-0 against Utah State, right? 7-10. Look at the average points per game, 102.4 with 79.7. And then last, we've got 53% field goal and 45%. So, yes, it might be a mismatch, let me tell you.
Yeah, but Utah State has something else on their side. They have passed these out to all the fans who will come to the game tonight. It's the gag rag.
Hey, 10,200 Tarkanians are going to be there tonight.
Follow his lead.
Maybe
two more right here on Big Monday. We'll be back and try and speak without the towels in our mouth. Back at halftime with scores and highlights. Up next, though, the number one team in the nation, a perfect 15-0, looking for that undefeated season.
The new Palace Station during our grand reopening and try the all-new Iron Horse Cafe featuring authentic Chinese cuisine and American fare, or the new Whistle Stop Snack Bar for great deli sandwiches, and the new Palace Saloon with nightly live entertainment. Our 600-room tower and new parking garage are just steps from all the fun. It's an all-new Palace Station. It'll be your favorite all over again.
Palace Station.
When you visit Arizona Charlie's, you can expect the warmest hospitality, the friendliest service, and the best values in Las Vegas. There's around-the-clock fun for everyone, from sports action you can bet on to cashing your paycheck and instantly winning up to $5,000. When it comes to entertainment, Arizona Charlie's Palace Grand Lounge features the hottest acts in town, South Decatur.
Aggies believe they can play them, but I believe they've got to play a near-perfect game, particularly stopping what's going on the inside.
You know, we always talk about one player at this point, and I think with Las Vegas, you could probably pick any one of about 10. But I kind of like to start with Larry Johnson.
That's a great place to start, Barry. Larry Johnson's an outstanding player. You can see his numbers there, 23 points, 11 rebounds. But what I really think he brings to the team is the enthusiasm, the ability to get the rest of the players to play hard all the time. In order for Larry Johnson to score, he must play well inside. Outside, they've got to have a good player to shoot the ball for him, and that's been Anderson Hunt. You see there, he's averaging 15 points a game. He's their three-point shooter. He's going because I believe the Aggies are going to collapse on the inside defensively, making Anderson Hunt make that shot.
Now to take a look at Utah State, this is not a team without talent. In fact, they have one guy who's a quality player who can't put the ball in the hole.
Kendall Youngblood is the player you're talking about. He played football in high school, All-American football player, could have gone anywhere in the country. Wanted to play basketball, chose Utah State, and has proven that he can play, averaging 16 points. Good athlete. He's got to get his athletic ability going. Had a tough decision whether to play football or basketball. I sympathize with him on that one.
Yeah, Quinn Buckner really likes Kendall Youngblood. I think there's a good reason for it. When we asked Conn Smith who Youngblood reminds him of, he said, you know, he reminds me of Quinn Buckner. We'll be back right after this.
Hey, Mrs. Susan Amato of Teaneck, New Jersey writes, I really want a Volkswagen Jetta, but what exactly does Farfignugen look like? Well, Mrs. Amato, did you see it? Farfignugen. It's what makes a car a Volkswagen.
Hello?
Hello, Jamie. How are you?
How you doing, buddy?
How'd you like the new music?
Great. Really great.
Well?
Where are the words?
How about checking your fax machine?
You're gonna love it. It's your
favorite key.
Hey.
Facsimile, one of a wide range of business communication solutions from Fujitsu, the global computer and communications company. Who guarantees overnight air delivery before 10:30 to the most people coast to coast? Who did you think?
It's powerful. It's 110% protection. Speed Stick deodorant, made just for a man. It has no alcohol to evaporate. Its protection doesn't fade. Speed Stick, 110% protection.
My name is Ona Fowler. I was born in the year 1906. I live here alone, and this is where I hope to stay. It's my home. Thank you very much.
ESPN's presentation of NCAA basketball, UNLV versus Utah State, is brought to you by Volkswagen. Experience the European driving experience we call Farfignugen, only in a Volkswagen. And by Budweiser, the king of beer. Remember, know when to say when.
Barry Tompkins with Quinn Buckner. We are back at the Spectrum here in Logan, Utah. Let's take a look at the lineups. First, for the visitors from Las Vegas. And Stacey Ogman going to be very much a key factor because he, of course, will get the defensive assignment on Kendall Youngblood. He had split halves against Youngblood. He gave up 21 to him in Las Vegas in the first half and shut him out in the second half. Johnson, Ackles, Hunt, and Anthony join him. Power-laden lineup, to be sure, for the number one team, coached by Jerry Tarkanian. And Jerry says simply, I love these kids. This is a terrific team with a lot of character. And what he's implying there, folks, is they may be better this year than they were last year when they won the championship. As to Utah State, they're going to go with a three-guard lineup and pay particular attention to Alan Gordon, because he is the guy that Conn Smith feels has to take care of the basketball, and Smith feels he does that better than anybody else. Kendall Youngblood, we've spoken of. Goodman, a good three-point shooter. Funk and Franson, and he's going to alternate four different big men and try to get a lot of different looks to Las Vegas as you look at Conn Smith. But it's a tall order. There's no question about it, Quinn.
Well, there's no question about it. Conn Smith, the Aggies crew, they can't turn the ball over. They've got to protect the inside, and they've got. And I agree it's a tall order, but the fun part about, I think, collegiate basketball is kids come out, they play hard, and with this kind of crowd, you just never know what the results can be.
Let's take a look at the game notes in this one, then. And UNLV just doesn't give up very much, and they take a lot. It's that simple.
Yeah, they get after you. You see, the 39% field goal percentage is what's really tough, 105 points. But you see, Utah State has had a problem with Vegas, 0 for 18. But here in the Spectrum, they've won 75% of their games. These kids, like with this crowd, they like to get out and get after it.
And you can see the crowd. They've lined up here starting at 7 o'clock in the morning this morning. And unlike a lot of places in the Big West Conference, Las Vegas being one of them, most of the crowd here is Utah State students.
Yes, and they got in early to get their seats, and they've been cranking it up since 7 o'clock.
Eric Franson, the jump center. Las Vegas controls the tip. This is Greg Anthony. Gordon works on him.
Man-to-man right out on the start. Main emphasis is to keep the ball out of the post, particularly from Larry Johnson.
Anderson Hunt misses his first three-point try. Ackles up over the top, guilty of a foul on the rebound. So the first team foul, and that first sequence goes very much the way Conn Smith would have liked it.
Vegas comes out in their man-to-man.
Funk down low, and they kick it out. Youngblood needs to get, according to Conn Smith, 15 to 20 shots. First of all, he's got to touch the ball, which he has not yet done. Goodman leans in, threw up a funny-looking shot, Franson fights for the rebound. He's not going to get it against Larry Johnson. Here come the Rebels. 2-on-2. Stacy Ogden drew the foul on Youngblood.
Well, knowing the weather Nevada, Las Vegas has to, you've got to get more people back. Kendall Youngblood is trying to stop Stacy Augment. Augment showing his hang time. But the real problem for the Aggies is they only had two men back on a 3-on-2. They've got to get back. They're not going to get many offensive rebounds, so they must protect against the defensive transition.
Let's talk briefly, Quinn, about what Conn Smith's plan is for kind of getting Larry Johnson out of the game, which is a very tall task. But he is going to try to double up on Johnson down low.
His plan of the percentages, Barry. What Tom really wants to do is to make Ackles shoot the ball. When Ackles come up, when they go into their high-low action, Conn Smith is going to let Ackles catch the ball and then try to keep Johnson from taking his action down low.
And on the offensive end, look for Utah State to run a lot of back screens and put the ball on the floor a lot. Just like that, Youngblood missed a shot. Franson gets it back, and he can't get it to go. So the Aggies did get two shots, didn't make good on any of them. We got to jump a foul call reaching in from behind on Goodman.
Very two early blown opportunities. Conn Smith knows that his team is not going to get many of those. They've got to put the layups in the hole.
And again, you see, Vegas will never walk the ball up the floor. They will burn it up the floor as they did right there. They will make you get back and play defense right now. Anderson Hunt for three. His second try is 0-for-2. Ogden fights for the rebound, put back short. Ogden gets it back. Third try, no good. Foul called underneath. And let's see who this is going to go against. I believe it might be Funk.
Well, Hunt is the guy you want shooting the basketball, but the action is vicious in there. And the problem is the Aggies don't block out. And you see right here, this is the third opportunity that the Rebels to get go for the basketball. And you see Stacy Augment give a little shove in there, but I think he was a little more frustrated than anything else.
They gave the foul to Franson, and Augment converts the free throw.
Well, one of the real problems Conn Smith's Aggies have had is that they've been a very poor rebounding team, Barry, and I think that's also going to be a critical part to what happens here. If they don't get the shots in, they've got to get rebounds, block out.
Perfect example right there. They got Augment to miss the free throw, but Johnson ran down the rebound. Greg Anthony for three. This is Gordon, and that's the man that Conn Smith wants to have start the offense, but this is the man he wants to have finish it.
Yeah, you want to get Youngblood the ball with a dribble so he can beat you off the dribble.
Goodman, a scoop shot, rejection by Ackles, and he not only rejected the shot, he batted it to his own man. That's off of Youngblood. I beg your pardon, that's going to be off of Anderson Hunt.
Well, that is a result of getting back in defensive transition that time. Just getting back, you cannot give up easy hoops for the Rebels. That's where they get the majority of their offense. Good defense.
Swatted away from behind. Loose ball on the floor. Picked up underneath by Larry Johnson. Here come the Rebels again at the free throw line. Augment. Kick back to Anthony. Waits for help. Augment.
Boy, has he really improved his jump shooting this year. Augment now taking the ball to the basket. Can make the three-point shot. Drew the defense. Took it to the basket.
And it is a 7-0 Rebel lead. And another turnover. And this time it was Ackles steps in front. Look out, Anderson Hunt. This is exactly what Conn Smith did not want.
No, they're forcing the action, Barry. Instead of making the defense move two or three times, the Aggies are trying to force it right away. You don't do that with the Rebels. You take what they give you.
And boy, is this a tough team to play catch-up on. Another turnover.
Lob.
3-on-1. Lob to Johnson. Pass from Anderson Hunt. And they are just killing the Aggies and taking the crowd right out of this game. 11-0. And we'll be back.
I burn with desire each time my heart fans the fire to that old flame that burns inside of me. Nobody in his right mind would have left her. Even my heart
of George Strait, brought to you by Bud Light.
Take your average family trip, but take it in a not-so-average family car, the new Volkswagen Passat. The Passat wagon comes with four-wheel disc brakes. It's got plenty of room for your family. And best of all, Farfignugan, which means you might even forget you're driving a family car.
Are we there yet?
Well, maybe not. Farfignugan, it's what makes a car a Volkswagen. Nice logo, too.
It's John Carlson on the phone from Los Angeles again.
Carlson?
He's from Apple Computer's ad agency. They want to do a commercial about us.
Would we get to be in the commercial?
No. Because we can't do it.
Why not?
Over the past 15 months, we've doubled our productivity. We've cut development time by a third.
That's what I mean.
Why would we go on national TV and tell our competition exactly how we did it?
It's a good point.
3 minutes gone. It's been all Las Vegas, and a transition game once again for Las Vegas.
Well, you don't take the ball in the corner with Nevada, Las Vegas, because there are too many hands. Stacey Augmon showing a little ball handling ability. And then right here, Anderson Hunt been shooting the ball. But that's the way you cap off the break to the big fella, Larry Johnson.
And the turnovers, as you see, Utah State 3 and UNLV 1. And even more important than that are the points off those turnovers. UNLV has converted every one of them.
Yeah, that's the real key. You get turnovers off the steals, and they convert right away. So you cannot afford to lose the ball when you're playing against the Rebel, or anyone else for that matter.
And those aren't cheap turnovers either. They have been forced, every one of them. Jardine in the game. Funk had the jumper, didn't take it. Jardine comes around, open for the jumper, won't go. Ackles the rebound, one shot only. Here come the Rebels. Three on two if they hurry. Ackles down low. Spin move. Everything but the shot. Johnson kept it alive, but finally Youngblood gets it. Ahead to Gordon.
Good pass.
Nice pass that time to Jardine. Missed the shot. Hunt gets the rebound. Going from bad to worse for the Aggies.
Well, they're missing these shots, but that's a good pass just to get it down there. You got to get it in the hole.
And the give beautifully from Johnson. Ogden missed the slam, drew the foul. Johnson drew three men to him and gave it up beautifully.
One of the things that has been questioned about Larry Johnson is, will he give it up? I think this answers all the questions here. He gets it, sees three men right away, makes the smart play, and Stacey Ogden takes it to the hoop, tries to finish it, but Randy Funk fouls him. Ogden looking for two free throws.
Ackles leaves, and Spencer comes on. Spencer at 7 feet. Let me mention this last week. We're probably worthy of note again. Only the second seven-footer that Jerry Tarkanian has ever had in Las Vegas.
Jerry Tarkanian normally gets the 6'7", 6'8", 6'9", athletes. What he's decided to do was to raise that height a little bit.
And still get athletes.
And still get athletes.
Ackles gets them both. It is a 12, one out of two, I should say, and it's a 12-0 game.
There needs to be patience on the offensive end down here by the Aggies.
Look at how active the Rebels are defensively, though. Move the ball really well.
That's patience.
And a good shot that time, but a miss once again. Down the other end, it's Johnson. Johnson to the basket, fouled by Jardine.
If you're going to play in this game, you've got to be aware of everything going on. This is one of the reasons they like Spencer. You see, that's the length of a court, left-handed baseball pass. And you see Johnson on the other end. That's a good hard foul on the part of Jardine. And initially, Larry Johnson thought about it. Maybe I should do something. Then he realized it's not a good idea.
Why hurt him?
Especially when you see what he's shooting from the foul line. I've got an opportunity to get two foul shots. He's shooting 90% here over the last, 10 or 12 games. So that's as good as making the shot.
Yeah, it's amazing. Even playing at the level that he did last year, where some people felt he might have been the first player picked in a draft, I honestly believe, Quinn, he's playing better this year.
Well, he's smarter this year. He that was his first 2 years of the competition. He knows how to play, Division I basketball, knows his teammates know him as well. Jerry Tarkanian wisely is taking advantage of all of Larry Johnson's skills.
13-0. 15:40 remaining in a half. What a dry spell for the Aggies. And it's been forced by the defense of the Rebels.
You're in this position, you've got to get to a foul line. There's somebody
Kendall Youngblood is the guy who's capable of getting to the foul line, taking it to the hole, getting the foul. What I'm trying to say is get some points on the board.
Youngblood, as we mentioned, they want him to get 15 or 20 shots. He's had one so far. 5 second call and another turnover. And once again, look at how quickly the Rebels bring the ball across the timeline. They just don't give you a chance to breathe. They leave Augman for the three and he sticks it. This is getting ugly.
It is, because that's been the question mark on Stacey Augman, and he's knocking that one down with ease.
Almost stepping in front again. Youngblood for the jumper, and there is the first Utah State basket. And once again, right back the other way. Anderson Hunt too hard off the glass, and a rebound coming down to Franson. Quick outlet to Goodman. Jumper is blocked that time. Franson can't get a shot off. Is that beautiful stuff? Huh.
I mean, I don't think there's any way that Spencer was going to get out there, and the next thing you know, he gets all of the basketball. Franson thought he had a wide-open jump shot.
Goodman for three.
You can't take that shot. You got to get it in the framework of the offense because this is what it'll lead to.
Two on one. Hunt again. This is Funk along the baseline. Stepping in front again is Hunt. Ahead it goes for Anthony. A fight for the ball. No call. Youngblood gets it. And Tommy Harrington now. I didn't see a call made, to tell you the truth.
He didn't make a call because two players were going for the basketball, and that's what Conn Smith was complaining about. He thought that his player got fouled, and I'm not sure that there's contact, but both players are going for the basketball, so the official let it go.
It's the right call.
I mean, and I don't know what else to do about it. It's just both players have to have an opportunity to go for the basketball. Jardine went down, and Conn Smith was talking to Harrington about it. That's the kids play basketball.
Raffner and Sager in the game now for Utah State just to try to generate something. Raffner, 14. Sager, number 50. This is Sager. Sager gives them a little size, but they give up a little on the quickness end. Spencer's open for the J. Sager has the rebound. Nice look underneath.
Good time. Look them off.
Funk with the basket. Spencer down low. Drew a crowd, made the shot.
But you can't guard him down there. Utah State cannot let Spencer get the ball. They don't have anybody tall enough to guard him. So you've got to put pressure on the passing.
That's got to be a foul on Ogden. As Ackles prepares to come back in the game.
Having not being able to get the ball anywhere they want, one of the things you want to try to do is take it to the basket. You saw Ruffner go down. There was no question about the foul. Ruffner just kind of sits there. But Augman doing a good job just trying to get around. Feet got tangled up.
Travis Bice has come on for UNLV. So too is Everett Gray. And he is instant offense. So is Bice for that matter. That's the thing that is so remarkable about Las Vegas. Anderson Hunt has missed a couple of threes. Funk misses a turnaround. So they bring Travis Bice on, who is equally adept at shooting the three. Gray down low to Johnson in traffic. Got it up. Couldn't get it to go. Gets it back underneath his hammer.
One of the things you want to see in any basketball player is that they play hard all the time. You see Larry Johnson right here. The ball could have gone out of bounds, but even more importantly, he could have stopped on it. He stays and goes after it. That's what you've got to admire about a player with all the recognition of a Larry Johnson. He plays hard all the time.
Roger Daly will come on for Conn Smith, and Smith already has played nine players.
Trying to find a combination. Just any way he can, want to get a combination.
Andy Funk leaves. Daly gives him a little bit of bulk. In fact, he's the Big West Conference discus champion.
I think that gives you a little bulk.
Doesn't give you height, though, unfortunately. He's only 6'7". One out of two, and Daly with a rebound.
The Aggies are going to make a run. They've got to make it with this group in.
Ruffner tried to go between two people, drew the block foul underneath.
On Larry Johnson, and the officials right on top of it.
What does that do to a game plan, though, Quinn, when the other team jumps on your 16-zip?
Throw it out the window. No, I don't think you can really afford to go away from your game plan, particularly when you have a team like Conn Smith has. This is a young team in terms of experience, and I think it's important for the kids to understand we had a game plan, we've got to try to execute it, and until we do, we can't honestly say whether or not it's worked. So the key is stay with it, execute it, and then let's make some adjustments.
Ruffner gets them both. 23-8 ball game. Foul's going to be called away from the ball on Larry Johnson. That's why that could have gone either way. I just happened to be watching at that point.
Well, the one thing Conn Smith does not want to do, you don't want to let Larry Johnson walk you down. And you see right here, there's a lot of contact in there. Fisher right on top of it felt Larry Johnson initiated it, makes the call.
I think now the job of the Aggies would be to try to get in. Blocked again by Anthony. And a foul, that's going to be on Goodman reaching in on Anthony. What I was going to say is, I would have to think Conn Smith would be very happy to get into single digits by halftime if he can do that.
Oh, absolutely, the way the team has started off. He just wants to see his team get in the sync. You know, I would have said right there that that would have been considered a good foul by Jake Goodman with the possible exception. And now you're looking at them going into the penalty. You see, just the hands, just the ability to cover so much distance. And right here, Greg Anthony just gets fouled. Because what I was saying is, Anthony got stopped from a fast break. A definite two. You put him on the foul line and make him earn his 2 points.
There you see the team foul situation. So a long way to go sending Las Vegas to the free throw line. 67% at the free throw line as a team for the Rebels. A little hard off the glass and a rebound finally to Daly. Ruffner leans in. Ruffner seems to have given him a little bit of a lift. And again at the other end, Ackles beating everybody down. It went off an Aggie, and it'll be Las Vegas' ball. But the Aggie's not getting back.
Not getting back. They're in between, Barry. They're not getting back, so they're not putting pressure on Greg Anthony bringing the ball down. And they're not getting back, stopping anybody from the Rebels team from getting good shots. So they've got to get the guards back. You got three guards in. One of them's responsibility has to be to get back and stop the fast break.
Spencer, lean-in jumper won't go. Sager keeps the ball alive, and it finally comes down to Ruffner. Reach-in foul that time, called on Spencer. Comes on and Everett Gray leaves for Jerry Tarkanian's running Rebels. Aggies seem to have settled down a little bit here. Goodman for three. And that's going to be on Sager from behind, I believe. Sager at 6'10", kind of interesting because on his high school team, he was the best three-point shooter on the team, which either means they didn't shoot it at all or he's a heck of a shooter.
I think it's a combination of the two. Right here, I'm sure Conn Smith would just like to see him get, you know, get on some boards here and keep Spencer out of the game. My man, Mr. Bice, the Charles Barkley fan.
Yeah, I was just going to say, he is your hero.
That's my man. That fragile body.
Spencer's second try to get the lead back to 15. Remember, Spencer wasn't available to this team until the 20th of December. One out of two for him, 24-10.
Those are the passes. Those passes that go from the wing back to the point are the passes that UNLV gets, both from the wing to the point and back.
Gordon getting in traffic, drew people to him, give it up to Daly, who missed a shot. Sager kept the rebound alive, but Spencer comes away with it for the Rebels. Good ball movement to Hunt for three. No good. 0 for 3. Anderson Hunt, incidentally, was 0 for 7 here last year as Ogden reaches in and commits the foul. So we will take a timeout with 11:23 remaining in the first half. Vegas out quickly. They lead by 14. It's 24 to 10.
Chris Kelly knows a little beachfront hotel where the view is breathtaking, but the prices aren't. Now, where do you suppose she'd rent a car? Budget, where she can reserve a car that's less than 6 months old in less than 3 minutes for a very relaxing price. The smart money is on Budget.
Now you can rent a Lincoln for the smart rate of $99 for any 3 days with unlimited mileage at any participating Budget location. The smart money is on Budget.
You know when it's right. You know when you feel it, baby. You hold it. You hear it. You taste it. It's right. You got the right one, baby. Unsurpassably callable and intimately soulful. You got the right one, baby.
Hey, Mrs. Susan Amato of Teaneck, New Jersey writes, I really want a Volkswagen Jetta, but what exactly does Farfignugen look like? Well, Mrs. Amato, did you see it? Farfignugen. It's what makes a car a Volkswagen.
This telecast is an exclusive presentation of Creative Sports Marketing, and there's the Creative Sports Marketing blimp right there in association with ESPN. Any use, rebroadcast, or other transmission of this telecast without the written consent of Creative Sports Marketing and ESPN is prohibited. So a little festivities inside the Spectrum here, an indoor blimp. We have a very small camera crew up there.
Yes, very a tiny camera crew up there. Now, the Aggies have fought back into the game, if you will, here, Barry. I really think it's important for them now to take their time. I've watched them go down on the deep, on their offensive end, and their spacing is what's become poor. And part of it is Nevada, Las Vegas, but you can pull the offense out and make Vegas come out and guard you and give yourself some opportunity to go to the basket.
And you see the shooting percentage of Utah State so far. That's just not going to get it done. And now, meanwhile, the blimp has remained in here, and the officials are saying, get the blimp out of here. Got to just get one of the Vegas players jump up and reject it.
The blimp.
And there is Big Blue. Interesting story with Big Blue here now. That's a new Big Blue. The other Big Blue was so good he got an offer from the Denver Nuggets. This is true. Accepted the other offer, $26,000. And Big Blue is now has another name, which I wrote down and I can't find right now. But I'll have that for you.
Enterprising old soul, isn't he? Got numbers again.
Anderson Hunt lobbed to Spencer. And a foul. Perfect pass from Hunt, though. Hunt is another guy that I really feel has picked his game up another level this year, and he was a terrific player last year, MVP in the tournament.
Well, there's no question about his ability to play. I'm not so sure that he's necessarily picked it up as much as Barry. There's been so much attention focused on Larry Johnson. People forget that Anderson Hunt, he's not only a great shooter, he can take the ball to the hole. Anderson Hunt is a scorer. It's a bit streaky, but he can score, showed his ability to draw the defense and kick at that time to Spencer, now shooting two foul shots. See, at this rate, it's not such a bad philosophy if you can afford it by personnel to start fouling UNLV, because they've proven they're not being consistent from the foul line.
0 for 2 there, too, but over the top is Ogden. Conn Smith feels he was illegally over the top. They just kick it in, kick it out, hook shot, misses everything. And the Aggies have a chance to get as close as they've been for a long time. Ruffner to the basket. They won't count that.
That's the third foul on Stacey Ogden.
And Johnson has a couple, too.
Oh, no, they called it. No, they got it on the other side. They called it on Anderson Hunt. Yes, Stacey Augman got away with that one because he definitely was fouling on the ball.
So Youngblood goes to the line. Youngblood with just 2 points. And they need more offensive production out of Kendall.
Well, you can believe that Jerry Tarkanian remembered that the fact that this young man, Kendall Youngblood, scored 21 points in the first half the last time that these two clubs played, and is making sure that he gets all of his defensive efforts centered around where Youngblood is.
They called that foul, incidentally, on Greg Anthony after all is said and done. Johnson, kick out. Hunt, in and out, 0 for 4 for Anderson. And in 2 years now, Anderson 0 for 11 from three-point range here.
He's streaky. He can get on real quick.
Goodman bounced off Spencer. Here's where they want the ball. Ruffner, who's been the offense, missed that shot. Sager kept it alive, but Johnson got it off the follow. And this time the Aggies get back defensively. Johnson in the lane, pulls up.
That's what makes him so difficult to guard, because the Aggies had kept the ball away from him on the inside, so he just comes out and he becomes the passer, and if you don't guard it, he can knock down the shot.
And again, it's turned up. But I tell you, the ball goes on the floor, and the Rebels are after it, and that's going to be a foul against the Aggies.
But you've got to protect the ball, and I didn't think that was a very good job right there protecting the ball, but you see, going in for it, it's Stacey Augman, and come out with the Rebels, and now they have a foul.
Randy Funk is the guilty party.
See, Spencer sucking a little air. First of all, we're up about at least 5,000 feet.
Yeah, and that's something that the Aggies gamble on. They feel that they beat opponents here because they can wear them down in the second half. And that could account for the fact that Jerry Tarkanian has gone to his bench a little bit earlier here.
Well, yes, he had a game with the Rebels on Saturday. You see right there holding his head is Jerry Tarkanian against the Louisville. And it turned out early that it was a tough game. And then they had to fly in here and play. And then you play up here in this altitude, it bothers you. There's no two ways about it. So he's doing a good job substituting. And Conn Smith likewise doing a good job trying to wear the Rebels down.
Goodman open for the three. Can't get it. Conn Smith was saying Goodman is a very good three-point shooter, but he sometimes pulls the trigger a little bit too soon.
And that was one time. He's streaky, and he was floating when he shot that shot.
Johnson, nice move. Put it on the floor. Got it beautifully for the hoop to Ackles. Boy, is that the way you draw it up?
It speaks for itself. What a play. Whoa.
I'll tell you, I like the guy better every time I see him. I liked him a lot the first time I saw him. Jumper that time is up and good by Eric Franson. 15-point UNLV lead. They jumped out 16-0.
Get it down to Johnson.
Ackles. They give it. He'll take it. This is Youngblood, and that's a tough shot. The other end, nice kick out by Ackles. Passes a little too long. Ackles with a presence of mind to kick it back out. Right across the lane, a little floater, and the shot won't go.
See, we got some help with the officiating here.
Yeah, that's right. Youngblood surrounded by three of the Rebels. It comes back to Ruffner. Gives it up to Goodman, and jumping over the top and fouling was George Ackles.
You said it was three of the Rebels. I guess I tell you what, if it was Kendall Youngblood, it looked like it was about six of them. You saw hands everywhere.
He draws a crowd.
Oh, just, boy, they're running people after him, getting the ball out of his hands.
Woo! Ruffner leaves, and he really did give the Aggies a lift, I think.
Yeah, he did. He came in and he pounded the boards a little bit, hustled. And that's what he's on the club for.
Ruffner, just a freshman.
You like kids like that, like Ruffner. He's not afraid to compete. And that's all you, again, that's all you want to ask is that regardless of what the score is, your kids play hard because that gives them a chance to be in the game.
And Jay Goodman converts two free throws, and the Aggies have it within 13. It's 31-18, 7:58 remaining, first half. We'll be back.
People find the 1991 Jaguar Vanden Pla quite beautiful. But what they don't see is the beauty inside. Polished woods, hand-stitched leather, and finely crafted details offer a uniquely elegant environment. The 1991 Jaguar Vanden Pla, it's beautiful no matter how you view it. Jaguar, a blending of art and machine.
The 1991 Jaguar Vanden Pla, exclusively at Chase & Motor Cars.
ESPN, the leader in sports programming, has captured 7 ACE Awards, cable television's highest honor. To all ACE Award winners throughout the cable television industry, congratulations from ESPN, the Total Sports Network.
31-18 ballgame. Actually, for about the last 7 minutes of this first half, UNLV has played Utah State, I should say, has played UNLV just about even. A reminder, more college basketball coming your way on ESPN tomorrow or Tuesday night. That is tomorrow night, isn't it? I've lost all track of time, days, and this is 1991. Kansas ranked 24 at Kansas State, a cross-state rivalry, and then in the SEC, Kentucky and Auburn. That'll be at 9:30 Eastern time.
Well, Kentucky is a team that everybody's talking about. They lost the other day to Alabama, but they've been playing well. And even though they can't go to the tournament, they're leading the SEC.
Rick Pitino doing a great job. Youngblood in there. And it's an 11-point game. And the Aggies started to get in sync a little bit here. 11-point game may not sound like much, but when you go down 16-zip, it's a lot. Anthony for three, yeah.
Well, that's one of the things that has started to happen, Barry, is that there were no perimeter shots being made by the Rebels, and they couldn't get the ball inside. And because of that, it allowed the Aggies to get more opportunities, and they were able to convert some of those.
Try that back screen, and France in travel. And that's the kind of turnover you really can't afford.
No, but it's all a part of that defense. I mean, you've got to be prepared mentally. And that's what's really tough about playing against a good defense like Nevada Las Vegas. You can't duplicate it in practice, so it's a first-time event for these players, and they're trying to respond and react simultaneously, and they just can't get it done.
Johnson in traffic. Forced that shot a little bit, and it is off of the Aggies. It'll be the Rebels' ball. And they will beat you on these inbounds plays, too.
Well, they got a lot of weapons, and they can lob it, and that's the play they like right there.
Not bad.
Because most people do not guard the guy who takes the ball out of bounds.
That was Ogman to Ackles to Ogman. And it's back to 16. Gordon down low on the baseline. Got it up amongst two Rebels, and the follow is up and good. I believe it was Franson.
Yeah, it was Franson.
Ackles at the other end. And that's what Las Vegas does to you.
Well, what you've got to do, you've got to put pressure on the guy bringing the ball up. As long as he's allowed to look up unencumbered by any hands, he can make lob passes like that.
At the other end, Jardine hammered underneath by Johnson or Ackles. I'm not sure. They might call that an Ackles. Third foul on Ackles. which will bring about the presence of Spencer once again.
Clearly, Spencer's going to get a chance to test his wind up here. You know, one of the problems you have when you haven't been in practice is you don't have the good conditioning, but it'll get tested up here at this 5,000 feet.
6:05 remaining, first half, 38-22. Vegas out 16-0, and they've kept that 16-point margin.
Selling a house is no vacation, but that's just what the Walkers got when they sold their house with our ERA office. The ERA Seller Security Plan guaranteed that if we didn't sell their house, ERA would buy it. ERA even agreed to take the risk of selling the house at a loss. When we sold it for more, the Walkers got the profit. The ERA Seller Security Plan, just the kind of help you'd expect from a friend. They used the extra money to take a vacation. They even sent me a postcard. List your house with an ERA broker. ERA, first in service.
The 1991 Buick Regal Sedan. It's going places. Regal features four-wheel disc brakes and an available 3800 V6 engine. Leather seating areas, concert sound, and anti-lock brakes are also available. Regal is going places in comfort with the spaciousness and Buick quality that gives its competitors fits. The new world-class four-door Regal from Buick. The new symbol for quality in America and beyond.
There's a new kind of cowboy out there. And that's why McDonald's is grilling up a whole new kind of steak. Topped with onions, mushrooms, and a hearty steak sauce on a sourdough roll with a side of fries. And right now, it's a great McDonald's value you can't pass up. McDonald's new grilled steak sandwich. A new kind of steak for a new kind of cowboy.
Big Monday continues in just a moment, but first a reminder, coming up at halftime, Jim and I will join you. We'll have highlights, including this game, number 8 Syracuse against Connecticut in a thriller. Right now, let's go back to the Big West.
All right, thank you very much, John Saunders. 38-22 ball game here, UNLV over Utah State, and they just jumped out 16-zip, and it's been an even game ever since.
They are really, Nevada, Las Vegas is a spurt team, and they do it on the defensive end. They cause you to make turnovers. They get 6-8 baskets, 6-8 points in a row, and then you just struggle to try to get back. And what happens, Barry, is you get so caught up in trying to get all your points back in one trip down the court that you end up making more mistakes and you just compound your problem.
Jardine converts the first free throw. Aggies have been no closer than 11 after that opening spurt. Jardine gets them both. That's a 14-point game. Now, one thing to keep in mind is that there are some of the Rebels in foul trouble, and that could be a factor. Anthony for three, yes.
Yeah, well, that's what kills you when you got both guards. I really think the guards make this team as good as they are, and I'll tell you why. They can put pressure on any guards in the country, and you cannot beat them off the dribble. And because you don't beat people off the dribble, you can't force help and dish off to somebody else, and then they can make the jump shot on the offensive end.
And another turnover. Anthony, incidentally, while Anderson Hunt hasn't been able to bury the three, Greg Anthony has three threes. And Ogden threw one in for good measure, too.
Got mismatches on both sides.
They get it in, and overplaying that time was Funk, and he got the foul on Johnson. A reminder that coming up at halftime, we'll take you back to the studios. John Saunders and Jim Valvano will tell you all about what the top 25 did tonight. We'll have Valvano's viewpoints. I kind of like that. I actually learned a lot of stuff from Jimmy V. That's all at halftime, 5 minutes and 19 seconds away. Meanwhile, UNLV 41, Utah State 24. And the Rebels just don't take any prisoners. It's just that simple.
Yeah, I think that's really a sign of a great team when you don't play necessarily to the competition. But I that is the one thing that I've got to say that you have to be careful of, is that all of a sudden you become so good you think you can turn it on and off, and then one day you get caught not being able to turn it on. That's how they can get beat.
Well, in fact, Jerry Tarkanian was not pleased at all with the way his bench players played in the game against Louisville. They won the game by 12. They were ahead by 30, and he brought some of his players off the bench, and they didn't perform the way he expects them to perform, and he was not happy at all about it.
And with good reason, because at some point during the season or during the tournament, those players coming off the bench in the Louisville game are going to have to support and or play substantial minutes in the game, and if they don't learn how to do it not right now, they clearly won't be able to do it when you get into championship play.
Youngblood can't get the free throw to go. It just seems that if anybody's going to beat Las Vegas, as you pointed out, they have to catch Las Vegas on a cold shooting night from the perimeter, have to get some of their big players in foul trouble, and have to shoot lights out themselves.
They've got to play almost a near-perfect game.
There's Anderson Hunt. And you don't want to get him started.
Yeah, I'm telling you, he's a streaky shooter, and when he gets on a roll, he'll start laughing and joking, and he'll hit them from anywhere.
First three-point shot he's made here in Logan, Utah in 2 years. So he was 0 for 2 years. Here's Goodman. Two of the Rebels there, and underneath it was Sager who got it back for the putback. Ogden had the shot, comes across the lane, gives it up nicely to Spencer, waits for help, draws the foul, count the basket.
Just like it's in the books, you take your time, you draw the defense. First of all, you can't let Ogden go to his strong suit. He's left-handed, got to force him to the other side, but he just throws it up here. Big fella shows real good patience, because I just knew he was going to throw that up too quickly. Showed the patience. Ogden, having made the jump shot, you have to go out and guard, and big fella again. Patience.
Well, that's just really quality stuff. That's all he could say. Youngblood working behind a Daly screen. Goes down low, this time to Sager for the turnaround. One shot, Johnson a rebound. Everett Gray, this guy could score in a hurry. Floats across, threw up a floater, got it back and put it in.
I mean, it almost gets to the point now that, you know, you got to start considering, do I just try to bring the ball back out some? And really just shorten the game, because now you take shots like this. This is all right if you make it, but if you miss it, that's your guard down on the baseline, and there's no way for him to get back on a fast break for the transition.
And the Rebels will inevitably make you pay that price. Kick out to Hunt. Three more. And both guards are shooting it good now.
Inside, outside. Once the inside game gets going, it allows those guys to shoot wide open jump shots on the outside.
And they also have Travis Bice in the lineup, and Travis Bice can really stick the three. That's a little scoop that time by Youngblood. And a rare turnover on the transition by the Rebels, and almost a travel by Daly. Youngblood gets it back too short. Anderson Hunt nicely for the rebound. Three on two, Hunt to the basket. Offensive foul.
Well, you have to see some good defense going right here. First of all, that shot was partially blocked, and Anderson Hunt, you know, he feels he can do anything. He had two places to go with it. Good position taken inside there. But I think the more interesting thing that has just happened is George Ackles has just been put back in the game with three fouls.
And there's still a ways to go here in the first half. 3:05. Now what do? Do you take it right to Ackles?
Oh, I'd go right at him. I mean, you make him play some defense and try to get him out of the basketball game. Low Spencer has been giving you problems. This is one way to get one of the top players, one of the starters, out of the game.
Rebels by 23. They clear out for Goodman this time, and he floats it up and missed it. But a foul underneath. And let's see who that's against. It's against Travis Bice. Stacey Ogden about to come back into the ballgame, and he will replace Ackles. So a very brief appearance for George Ackles, and Tark will get him out of there, most likely for the rest of the half, I would imagine.
It is, and what Tark did, somebody reminded him that Ackles had three fouls, because when George came off the court, Tark walked over to him and put up three fingers. I just think it's one of those things that just slipped Tark's mind. But if you're a point guard on Utah State, that's the first thing you've got to see is the guy's coming in the game and you expose him, and don't give Tark that luxury to be able to get him out.
This is Gray.
You got posted up by himself is Larry Johnson.
Just watching Daly try to work on Johnson under there. Three-point shot, Travis Bice, as indicated.
You like to keep options. Rebels got a lot of them offensively.
That was Goodman, a very tough shot. Johnson the rebound. Here's Bice. Look out. Missed it. Everett Gray fighting Daly for the rebound. Daly gets the rebound over Gray, and here's Youngblood. Youngblood forced that shot. That was a shot of desperation right there. Bice squares up again. Doesn't take this one. Gray will. That one's short. And the rebound to Francis. They want a foul on Gray. They won't get it. Ruffner to Youngblood. Bice steps in front. Ahead it goes to Johnson. This ought to be pretty.
Don't waste your time getting down here to foul him. He'll throw you and the ball in the basket.
He was very gentle with that, actually. Franson with three Rebels around him.
That was the best pick and roll that the Aggies have executed all night. Got the play of Franson rolling to the basket, take it up strong, try to draw a foul.
There's Ogman with the left hand, too hard. Johnson will follow that one in. And Larry Johnson now with 12. Goodman leans in. Nice little runner by Goodman. But trading baskets isn't going to get it done.
No, not exactly going to get it done with this group.
Well, to put this in perspective, the Aggies played Las Vegas to a two-point game at halftime in Las Vegas. Now here we are in Logan, and they lead by 24. UNLV won the first game by 32.
The Aggies shot 48% and had seven threes in that game, so it was not like they played a bad game.
Foul is called away from the ball against Everett Gray.
Well, you've got to have some patience, and Everett Gray is trying to explain it, but what's going to happen? You see, he step out here, and he takes a shot. I'm not so sure that he hit anybody quite that hard, but Goodman did the thing. If you get an opportunity to draw the foul, you draw it. But I want to tell you something. Greg Anthony was really upset with Everett Gray. You know, you've got the ball in your hands and the chance to run the clock down. You can't afford to get those kind of senseless fouls.
Now, Greg Anthony has really taken over on the floor.
Welcome back once again, everybody, on Big Monday. As you can see, we have temporarily lost our feed from Utah State, but Jim Valvano, as we looked in this game, it looked as if Utah State had lost the feed early on.
I'd say one of the impressive things, John, about Las Vegas this year is their ability, both at home and on the road, to be so focused. They come out, and every game we see, they go out to a two-touchdown lead early and then kind of coast. And it shows you how remarkably poised they are and really, I think, looking for down the road to winning the whole thing.
Yeah, Jerry Tarkanian has told you earlier this year that he's shooting for the undefeated season.
I said to him, I said, Tark, it might be good if you lost a game this year. Kind of help you out the way UCLA lost to Houston a long time ago. And he kept saying, mm-mm. I said, what? He said, no, we would like to win them all. And I'm telling you, his kids seem to want to do that, too.
Yeah, Indiana that year, they went undefeated, winning the tournament, and then lost. Tark would like to win all the way to a second straight national championship. That goes without saying. Stay with us. Halftime in just a moment. UNLV with the lead over Utah State. Big Monday continues.
Of all
world's car lines sold in this country, J.D. Power & Associates ranks only one American among the 10 most trouble-free. Buick. Before you put a new car in your garage, make sure it has one of these on the hood. Quick, which luxury car gets better highway gas mileage? Lexus LS400 or this Buick Park Avenue? Most people guess Lexus. Most people are wrong.
Through the years, you've never let me down.
You've turned my life around. The sweetest days I've found with you. Through the years.
From dishwashers to clothes washers and dryers, a KitchenAid will last through the years.
And I'm so glad I stayed right here with you.
Wondered what it's like to experience the Bavarian Alps. You don't have to go there to find out. Just head for Vail, Colorado and the Sun and Alp Hotel. And you'll get a taste of champagne powder snow and the richest Bavarian cream pie this side of Innsbruck. So if you go, get your skis waxed up and put your Visa card down. Because at the Sun and Alp, they take fun seriously, but they don't take American Express. Visa, it's everywhere you want to be.
Presentation of NCAA basketball. UNLV versus Utah State is brought to you by Buick, the new symbol for quality in America, and by Visa. It's everywhere you want to be. Welcome back once again. UNLV leading 64-37 at halftime in the Big West game here on Big Monday. And Jim Valvano, we talked about it before the game. We knew this one was not going to be the title fight you were looking for. Well, I said that it might be Mike Tyson against Michael Jackson.
And what happened? It wound up Mike Tyson against Cecily Tyson. You said that. I did. But the fact of the matter is Vegas has done its usual outstanding job on both ends of the floor. What we have right here is Utah State early on having trouble scoring, tried to run a pick and roll. But look at Vegas, the space right here. The whole team is getting ready to make a play on this particular offensive segment. And now what happens, Utah State makes another mistake. Utah State player brings the Vegas player to the ball. Watch what happens here. Now we get the steal. We've got Stacey Ogden between the legs to Anderson Hunt. Boom. And Vegas probably finishes off the break as well as any team in the country.
Yeah, it was 16-0 at one point. Two touchdowns and a safety before Utah State got on the board. However, earlier here tonight on Big Monday, we did have a tight one. That in the Big East, number 8 Syracuse facing Connecticut. The Huskies coming into this game, now at home, they had lost 5 consecutive games all in the Big East. Chris Smith to Scott Burrell. Burrell takes it up, gets bumped as well, but Syracuse comes right back. Scott McCorkle, nice pass to Dave Johnson, who hangs on the baseline. Tied at 33 at halftime. In the second half, Billy Owens down low and gets fouled. The Orange are up 67-65. Then with time running out, one-point game, Syracuse up. Chris Smith with the steal. The easy layup right, he misses. Then DeVries misses the tip. Another chance, though. Smith gives it to Gwynn. And watch the time. It expires before Gwynn gets the shot off. Jim Calhoun cannot believe it. And I can understand why. He's lost for the 6th consecutive time, the longest losing streak at Connecticut. They lost only 6 games all of last year. David Johnson with 27 points for the Orange. Billy Owens, 15 points, 16 rebounds. Chris Smith, 25 points in the losing effort, but couldn't get the last shot. Also in the top 25, Marshall at number 16, East Tennessee State. This in the Southern Conference. East Tennessee State, one of the surprise teams early on this year, but they would be in a tight one early tonight. Coming together as a team, Mr. Jennings feeds inside to Rodney English, a big slam. Jennings again to English, baseline explodes over everyone and jams it down. 44-36 at halftime. Marshall keeps it close, though. John Tapp, double clutches, three-point play. Marshall within 2. Buccaneers cut off the inside game. Calvin Telford skies the block. Troy Taylor. Marshall goes outside. Brett Vincent hits the long 3. Buccaneers too strong. Keith, Mr. Jennings, alley-oops for Telford. 99-88 would be the final. The 16th-ranked team in the nation. The winner, Rodney English, with 24 points in the game. Calvin Talbert had 23. Mr. Jennings, 15 points and 9 assists. Stay with us. There's more to come. We're at halftime in our game in the Big West here on Big Monday. More to come. We'll hear from Jim and more highlights in just a moment. Stay with us.
The fastest growing name in auto parts today. Pronto, featuring quality auto parts at lower prices. Pronto oil and air filters are designed to meet or exceed your car's original manufacturer's specifications. Pronto oil and air filters provide the protection demanded by today's high technology engines.
When you need to know about auto parts, ask the pro at Pronto.
Have you checked the batteries in the flashlight lately?
Yeah, sure. I'm
dead. A reminder to check your batteries with the copper top tester. It's free and only from Duracell.
Do yourself proud. Make you look beautiful. Do it for yourself with Minwax and Wood.
Get beautiful color with Minwax Wood Finish and lasting protection with Minwax Polyurethane.
So do yourself proud with Minwax and Wood.
What do we have here?
Acute lower abdominal pain.
I don't see any alternative.
I don't either. We have to go in. Have we gotten the parents yet?
I have them on the phone, doctor. They're out of the country.
Fax them a consent form, stat.
That's the only thing we're waiting on.
I don't know it.
Okay. Got it. Any minute. Doctor, I've got the parents' signatures.
Excellent. Here we go.
DEX Facsimile, one of a wide range of business communication solutions from Fujitsu, the global computer and communications company. Now that spells relief.
Meantime, welcome back to Big Monday. UNLV with a 27-point lead at halftime at Utah State. In the second half, still to come, but let's quickly check some more scores and highlights. Call this one the Battle of New Orleans. The Green Wave of Tulane and the Privateers of New Orleans, ranked number 22 in the nation, on a move, having won 17 straight games. But G.J. Hunter with a long three here. The Green Wave still down 83-81 in overtime. New Orleans pass gets away. David Whitmore hits the three as time expires. And Tulane will win this game 84-83 in double overtime. Here's the pass getting away. Time running down. The three-pointer is up, and Tulane has the victory. The crowd goes crazy on the floor as they knock off New Orleans, ranked number 22. Doing a little cabbage patch, dancing down there in New Orleans. 84-83 is the final. New Orleans had won 17 games in a row. Four out of five starters for Tulane fouled out of the game. They still won the game. Kim Lewis with 16 points. Michael Christian had 15 points. Jim Valvano, we all know about New Orleans because under Benny Deese a couple of years ago, they had a good run. But Tulane, a program trying to get back on their feet.
Yeah, John, Tulane's got to stop dancing after victories like that unless you can get a choreo. Maybe MC Hammer can go help him. But Perry Clark, who is the coach of Tulane, I've known him quite some time. He was a player when I was a coach. A lot of people don't know he was Bobby Crimmins' assistant at Georgia Tech, and he's really taken on a big task getting that program going, and I know it's such a big win for him, and congratulations to him. He's an outstanding coach.
Always a great win to knock off a top 25 team, especially when they're another team from New Orleans. Let's move along now to the Big Ten, where we were earlier here tonight on Big Monday. Iowa and Illinois, a couple of teams that, simply put, do not like each other for various reasons. The main had to do with Deion Thomas and his recruitment at Illinois. That's Iowa assistant Bruce Pearl. He apparently blew the whistle on Deion Thomas. Thomas, though, was proven right later on. Low-scoring first half. Big Ten block leader A.C. Earl. Iowa down five at halftime. Andy Coffin with a spin move. The pass to Thomas gets the layup. Illinois leads by as many as 15. Kevin Smith's three-pointer to tie at the buzzer will not go. Dr. Tom Davis has to leave with the loss. Bruce Pearl loses this round. Iowa, a loser at Illinois, 53-50. Smith with 16 points and 13 rebounds. Andy Kaufman, 14 points. Iowa, 3 of 12 from free throw range. Miami at Wake Forest, the loser, 72-66. Randolph Childress had 23 points in the game. Rodney Rogers, 19 points, 9 rebounds. DePaul and Marquette. DePaul gets the win, 84-56. Warriors now 6-12. David Booth with 16. Terry Davis had 15. DePaul went on a 22-0 run in the second half. Atlantic 10, Temple over Rhode Island, 76-61. Mark Macon, as usual, with his 29 points. Mick Kilgore had 23 points and 8 rebounds. Also in the Atlantic 10, Rutgers a winner at Penn State by 179-78. The Knights, their fifth consecutive victory in this one. Earl Duncan with 18 points, including the winning free throw with just 9 seconds left in the game. But Keith Hughes, who was also a transfer from Syracuse a couple of years ago, 40 points, 9 rebounds, and 5 three-point field goals for the Scarlet Knights of Rutgers. Stay with us. When we come back, we will have more on Big Monday here. The Big West still to come. 27-point deficit. Here's a look at some more scores here on Monday night.
Uncomfortable you can feel when you're shopping for a car, especially if you're a woman. Some salespeople just don't take women seriously. They think the most important thing to us about a car is its color. They ask if our husband or boyfriend came along. They call you sweetheart. At Fletcher Jones Toyota, all of our salespeople treat you with respect and dignity, like the valued customer you are. Because at Fletcher Jones, we never underestimate the power of a woman.
Irresponsible. Just because the other guy is on the road doesn't mean his mind is. So the superb traction of the Subaru Legacy with four-wheel drive and anti-lock brakes can be quite a comfort. Since the next guy is capable of almost anything, shouldn't the same be true of your next car?
Now's the best time to make a great deal on a Subaru and save with factory to dealer incentives.
Back 64-37 is our halftime score. UNLV leading over Utah State. Is there any way Utah State and the Aggies can get back in this game? What do you look for in the second half?
Can they get back in the game? No, as a matter of fact, no. The thing would bring pull the bus around. You know, there's going to be more of the same. Vegas is just that good.
When you look at these teams, and you look at Vegas in particular, and everyone's wondering whether they can have the undefeated season, and you alluded to it before, the intensity that Jerry Tarkanian has his players at, how does he keep that up for the rest of the year?
I think, John, that the adversity that they have faced, and I know about adversity, and it does one of two things. It either tears you apart or it brings you together. And I think in Vegas's case, everything that's happened has just brought them together for one thing, and that is they're going to repeat. You know, we had to one it, repeat, three-peat, whatever it is, and they do it each day. And I've been to their practices. They work so hard, and they do it in practice, and they do it in games.
All right, stay with us. There's more to come. Unfortunately, more to come for Utah State. Down by 27, trying to get some respectability right now here on Big Monday. We're just about done in the Big West.
A new kind of cowboy out there, and that's why McDonald's is grilling up a whole new kind of steak, topped with onions, mushrooms, and a hearty steak sauce and a sourdough roll with a side of fries. And right now, it's a great McDonald's value you can't pass up.
McDonald's new grilled steak sandwich. A new kind of steak for a new kind of cowboy.
Amtrak has the best priced views of America. Whether you travel in any one region, or two regions, or all three regions of the country, Amtrak's All Aboard America fares take up to 45 days, take three stopovers, and take your camera.
What can a Toyota one-ton truck do for you? Haul a 2,510-pound payload. Tow 5,000. And with 150 V6 horses, harnessed to Toyota's never-say-die reputation, what can't it do for you? Nothing.
I love what you do for me, Toyota.
ESPN's presentation of NCAA basketball, UNLV versus Utah State, is brought to you by your Toyota dealers and their quality line of cars and trucks. Toyota, I love what you do for me. And by Campbell's Chunky Soup, the satisfying stop that keeps you going.
Barry Tompkins with Quinn Buckner. We are back in Logan, Utah, where the UNLV Running Rebels have played about as good a half of basketball. And we've seen him, I don't know how many times in the last couple of years. I haven't seen him play any better. I'm just sitting here kind of thinking, Quinn, what does Jerry Tarkanian say to this team during halftime? Go out and shoot your free throws better? They did everything else.
Well, they did. The thing that they did, I think, the best was they played great defense. I mean, they forced a team to shoot 35% from the field. You tell your team you've got to concentrate because you don't know how the Aggies will come out and play in the second half. And I think it's important that the Rebels come off and get a good start going into the second half because you want to remove any doubt that the Rebels are the best team. And that's what I would do if I'm Jerry Tarkanian.
Incidentally, we do apologize to you for losing our signal back to Bristol, Connecticut, and therefore to you toward the end of the first half. What you missed, basically, was more of what you saw, because UNLV just did it all right. I mean, that wasn't so much what the Aggies didn't do, it was really what the Rebels did do.
And I think that's going to be the case for the Rebels all year. You see Larry Johnson putting the ball on the floor and then finding Ackles underneath for the dunk. You want to know what Larry Johnson can do? You've seen him make jump shots. You've seen him get it in underneath, and you see he can pass it off. On the other side, the Aggies had one positive sign in that after a fast break, they're able to push the ball up the court one of the few times. And this is the young man we said at the top of the show needed to have a good game, Kendall Youngblood, showing his ability to push the ball up the court, get it in the basket. He ended up with 12 points. Didn't get a lot of support from the rest of his teammates. I think that's what really hurt him. You see the stats right there. The 35% is absolutely the key. You see, the turnovers we talked about, Barry, have not been significant in the fact that Utah State has 9 until you see the 7 for UNLV. The rebounds, obviously they can make up something here. The three-point shooting, I thought, is something that Aggies need to do, and they really haven't done that. You talk about the leading scores, and you look at it, as you expect, Augman Johnson and Hunt, 13, 12, and 12. Kendall Youngblood getting some support, but not the kind he needs for the Aggies to get a victory here. They're playing against a tough Rebel team, and the Rebels are coming out here, and I'm sure Jerry Tarkanian gave his team a piece of his mind. Believe it or not, this is when a coach will get tough on you, knowing you got a lead like this because you're subject to relax.
I'm sure he talked to his reserves because this was the situation as Youngblood gets the Aggies off to start the second half. This is the situation he was in at Louisville on Saturday. And that is that he built a big lead, then the reserves came on, and the lead dwindled down to the final result, which was 12. I don't think Tark wants to see a repeat of that.
All a lack of concentration.
Well, the Aggies get a chance to start out with back-to-back baskets here, but Ruffner has it rejected by Ackles. Remember, Ackles playing with three fouls to start the second half, and he almost got that one, too. Augman runs it down. Nice play by Youngblood because that was going to be a gimme basket for Anderson Hunt.
Well, Youngblood, a defensive back, doing a good job anticipating that pass. Said this young man could have gone anywhere in the country as a defensive back. All-American in high school. Wanted to play basketball.
From just down the road in Ogden, Utah. Anderson Hunt to the basket off the glass. Hunt now has 14.
Reppner, the jumper at the line. What a bad shot, just didn't go. It's going to be off of Larry Johnson. The Aggies will have another try.
You know, you come in out of this halftime, I think the real question is, what does Tom Smith tell his team? And what he has to tell the guys is, look, we understand what you're going through, but you've got to continue to play hard and do what we want you to do, because in the long run, you'll be successful with it. So you can't change your game plan right here. You've got to just play hard.
And Conn Smith starts the second half with the team that was the most productive for him. That is Ruffner playing, Sager playing. Those are two players who did not start the game. And it's Youngblood, Goodman, and Funk. For Las Vegas, same lineup that started the game. Hunt and Anthony in the backcourt. Ogwin, Johnson, and Ackles up front. And Johnson is hammered by Sager as he goes to the basket.
He got away with a walk, too. There's no question about it. If you watch this play, you'll see right here, Larry Johnson will get the ball, and he'll come to a stop, and then he'll take off again. He stopped, and then he hops with both feet. There's no question he traveled, and the official didn't get him on it.
So Johnson will go to the free throw line. 4 out of 5 at the line in the first half. He was the best free throw shooter for the Rebels.
You know, that you talk about trying to have a smooth rhythm. Larry Johnson has this hitch in his shot, and he's still able to knock it down at a 90% clip.
There just isn't a weak spot in his game. And pro scouts that I've talked to, with the possible exception of Shaquille O'Neal coming out, seem to be united in the thought that Johnson will be the first player picked this year.
What you'll always take is a big, strong athlete who will work hard. Larry Johnson is a 6'9", strong athlete, works hard. Boy, and Shaquille is a 7-foot athlete that gets right after it.
That was Youngblood at the other end, and Ogman in the lane for the Rebels.
Ooh, that was a big-time shot, because he went right to the contact.
This time ahead of the pack. It's Funk for the reverse. Ackles got a piece of it, but Ruffner followed it in. Sager guilty as Johnson just gets position, and he's just immovable in there.
And you're not going to get it going over the top. Sager's got to learn that. I mean, there's just no way you're going to get that kind of you're going to get the ball going over the top. If you lose position, you just have to stay behind and not foul.
Daly will come on to replace Sager for Conn Smith. Sager just a freshman. Conn Smith really has the makings of a very big, strong team. Tell you why in a minute. Hunt rejected that time by Daly. Back to Anthony. They get it back to Johnson for the reverse.
One of his favorite moves. That's what I've noticed about Larry Johnson. 9 times out of 10, he'll go to the other side for the shot, particularly if he goes to his right hand. A shot blocker will learn that at the next level, and they'll make him dunk it on the strong side. But that's a heck of a problem to have.
The miss from outside. Youngblood gets it back, puts it in off the glass. He's got 6 quick ones in the second half. But Anthony burns everybody back the other way. Too hard off the glass, but he drew the foul. What I started to say before about Utah State is they do have Ruffner at 6'6", is a freshman out of Provo, who, of course, will be back for 3 more years. Franson, who at 6'8", is a freshman. Then Sager, who you saw just leave at 6'10", is a freshman. Plus, next year, coming into the program, is Nathan Wickheiser. He has been on a Mormon mission for the last 2 years, so he will come in as a freshman, and they'll get 4 years out of him. He's a 7-footer at 260, who Conn Smith says can play.
Well, not only that. See, the good thing about the mission is these guys come back 21 years old. They're men, so they're mentally tougher than you see the average college freshman at 18 years old. Now, the other thing to take into consideration with that, Barry, is Jay Goodman is only truly played this year. He played at Iowa State 2 years ago, but that was as a walk-on. It didn't work out for him, and he wanted a scholarship, so the place he got a scholarship was here. So this is his first full year of major competition as well.
Hunt for 3, missed the shot, and of course Kendall Youngblood is back for another year too, so this is going to be a team to be reckoned with in the Big West next year.
Conn Smith feels very strongly that this is going to be a much better team next year.
Ogman can't get it. The rebound down to Funk.
You got to make solid plays. You're not going to be able to beat Nevada, Las Vegas making plays like that Jay Goodman tried to make. Good, solid plays. Easy passes.
They get it down low to Ackles. Ackles looks for the shot, but that time he traveled before he took it.
Got the little bunny hop.
Goodman all the way to the basket, floats it up. He lost Anderson Hunt somewhere in traffic there. Ogman got Ruffner by him, gave it up nicely to Hunt, who takes it to the basket. Credit Stacy Ogman. Youngblood pulls up. Daly tries to follow, gets it back for the putback, and drew the foul as well.
You like players that play hard. This is one thing Kendall Gill has not been able to do. He has not been able to beat Greg Anthony off the dribble, but if you get your teammates staying after the ball, you can see the results as Daly knocks that down. I like Daly, and I'll tell you why. He took a shot from Larry Johnson, and he never budged on the other end. And he came back on this end, had two opportunities to tip it in, took a nice little shot. I mean, physically got hit. But you can see with guns like that, that's what we call those arms, those guns, he can take a lot of shots.
He's one of 13 children. I'm sure he has taken a lot of shots. We'll take a timeout. 15:38 remaining in this one. Las Vegas, 75. Utah State, 50. And we'll be back right after this.
I see you've selected the ultimate adventure. Vehicle preference?
Toyota 4x4, the black one.
Excellent choice. Oh no, we've lost another one.
A 1991 Toyota 4x4, the ultimate adventure.
My son, Jeff, one busy guy, but he will drop everything for Campbell's Chunky Soup. With delicious chunks of vegetables and meat, Chunky's quick to satisfy, so Jeff can pick up right where he left off.
Campbell's Chunky Soup, the satisfying stop that keeps you going.
Genesis does.
Who does the hottest ever video football game you've been waiting for?
Genesis does.
Who does real 16-bit sports action like only the world's greatest quarterback can?
Genesis
does.
Genesis
does. Who gives you $30 cash back when you buy a new Sega Genesis system?
Genesis does!
Buy a Sega Genesis system now and get $30 cash back.
Who guarantees overnight air delivery before 10:30 to more businesses than anyone else in the business? Who did you think?
75-50 ball game, UNLV over Utah State. This game was over for all intent in about the first 6 minutes when Utah State ran it out, or rather UNLV ran it out to a 16-0 lead. More basketball coming your way Wednesday. ACC and Big East. In the Big East, St. John's and Georgetown, numbers 5 and 18. They get it on beginning at 7 o'clock Eastern time. And then after that, down to the ACC, where it'll be Duke and Georgia Tech. And Tech playing pretty good right now.
They are playing pretty good. They had the big win over North Carolina, having not won over there in the Dean Dome. So they've got to be feeling pretty confident about themselves. But they've also got to be careful of a letdown.
Spencer in the game now for Jerry Tarkanian's Running Rebels. Ogman across the lane, forced the shot, but drew the foul, I think, against Ruffner. And that will put Stacy Ogman at the free throw line.
You know, when you play against Stacy Ogman, he's left-handed. First of all, he likes the middle, and he will go to, if a guy gets in trouble, they do what they do most instinctively. Force him to his weak hand, which is his right hand.
Six of 11 at the free throw line for Ogman. Missed them both. Daly the rebound.
Going into the, what they call the amoeba defense. It's like a 1-1-3. It ends up being a matchup.
And it is a monster.
You can still penetrate the seams on it. It's not unlike any other zone that you'll play against.
Ruffner.
Take it up.
Amongst the trees. Did a good job just to get the ball up. Ogman gets it back. Length of the court to Anderson Hunt. They're looking for the lob. He got the ball to Johnson, who put it off the glass and drew the foul. Johnson wanted the lob that time.
that, but he got himself in a tough position to get a lob. So Anderson Hunt did the wise thing just to get it to him. This is just good effort. I thought Daly had a good shot at the ball. Anderson Hunt, you can see he has the angle, but he's ready to try to find his own shot. He's like, Larry, you get this one off the glass.
Patterson comes into the game for the first time for Conn Smythe. Gary Patterson, a sophomore out of Redmond, Washington. Larry Johnson continues to stick it at the free throw line. Greg Anthony ran over to Tom Harrington and said something, and I'm not sure about... I think he's pointing at somebody in the crowd behind the basket.
They were waving, and I'm not sure exactly what it was while Larry Johnson was shooting, and they're being told that if they do that again, that'll be a technical foul.
And that's perfectly within Greg Anthony's rights. A camera, he said. So it was a flash, I assume, is what he's saying.
Maybe just a fan wanting to get a picture of Larry Johnson shooting the foul shot.
Exactly.
Looks like it bothered Larry. He's chewing gum, relaxed.
Yeah.
Made the foul shot.
I've never seen any other expression on Larry's face, to tell you the truth.
Like a day at the park to him. Put the camera back on.
Yeah. And Augman gets the rebound. Johnson wants the ball here. Great ball movement. Anderson Hunt missed the three, but boy, what ball movement. They're going to get Johnson over the top of Daly. Sure like the way they kick it in, kick it out.
It works every time. Inside, the defense has got to collapse, Barry. Once it does that, the perimeter's wide open, and they have two very good perimeter shooters in Anderson Hunt and Greg Anthony, and one turned out to be a decent shooter in Stacey Altman.
Tried to go back door that time to Daly, and Johnson stepped in front. He does it at both ends. Hunt, lob down low to Spencer. Off the glass and in.
I want to know what Kendall Youngblood was thinking about, trying to lob against Nevada, Las Vegas.
Yeah, I know, that's true.
Are you kidding me?
Again, tried to go down low, and they're going to get the foul on Spencer. Watch the pass from Anderson Hunt just a minute ago.
Well, when you got the threat of being a jump shooter, you see right there Kendall Youngblood comes out, and then just a nice little drop step. That's actually traveling. Official didn't get today because he came to a jump stop, but it's a nice little pass inside Anderson Hunt because he's been making so many three-pointers.
Well, Gordon had a shot there, didn't take it. Gordon doesn't look to shoot the ball. He was scoreless in the game against New Mexico State. And Conn Smythe wants a timeout. And we'll take one, too, with 13:32 remaining in this game. And UNLV comfortably in front. They lead it by 28, 78-50.
Economists say we're in for some stormy weather. Happily, there is a bright spot. Right now at your Hyundai dealer, you can buy this V6-powered Sonata, a roomy midsize sedan with automatic and stereo, and get air conditioning at no extra charge. Plus, $750 factory cash back means it's only $11,420. So get a big car for less than a lot of small cars, and you'll be singing in the rain. See your Hyundai dealer now. It could be the smartest economic move you make all year.
Sir, I want you to stand right here for me, okay?
Okay.
Okay, go on in. Get your hands out of your pocket. Go ahead and stand face me. Put your heels and toes together. All the way together. All the way together. Okay, you see my pen right here in front of your eyes?
Yes.
I want you to follow my pen, okay? With your eyes only. Okay, sir. Go ahead and turn around. You have anything in a gun?
No.
Go ahead and turn around. Give me hands to the back. Okay, you're under arrest for DWI, sir, okay? We're going to go downtown for intoxicated test, okay?
Good times with friends, hey, they're special. Sometimes you wish they would never end. The care you show is just as special.
Friends know when to say when.
The family of Budweiser Beers is proud of all the friendships they've helped make.
So when they remind you to know when to say when, it's all in the name of friendship.
Friends know when to say when.
Quinn, you just made a point while we were away that ought to strike terror in some people's hearts. You said, and you're right, UNLV is a second-half team.
They really do. They go in after the halftime, and I don't know what it is in the water or what Jerry Tarkanian says to them, but they come out, and they'll get you three or four possessions down the court on your offensive end. You won't get a good shot, and you may not get a look at the basket, and they'll convert it. And, boy, that just demoralizes you coming out getting no opportunity early in the half.
There's an example right here with the turnover forced by Tracy Ogman. They just have hands on the ball at all time, it seems.
They have bodies all around the ball.
That was a nice effort by Greg Anthony, only Spencer couldn't find the handle, which is one of the things that Jerry Tarkanian said about Elmore Spencer, that once he gets the ball in his hands, he's a potent offensive weapon, but he's had a little problem getting the ball in his hands, and an example was right there. Stacey Ogwin tried to slam it, and instead he slammed Tom Harrington.
Well, I'll tell you what, we were talking about Spencer. He made a nice little drop pass to Ogwin. So he'll show you some ability. If he gets the ball in his hands, this is the kind of thing that he can do. He catch Stacey Ogwin, again, coming to his left. But he's the question here was whether or not Spencer could do something with the ball once he got it. He proved that he can pass it.
And Ogwin gets that free throw. Stacey Ogwin with 16, very balanced scoring. Ogwin now with 17, Johnson with 17, Hunt with 16 for UNLV, and Greg Anthony's contributed 10, three of them on threes, or nine of them on three-point shots.
All day. If you get the ball there, they missed the shot, but that's the play. Get it in the middle, and you get lobbed.
Nice defensive job by Gordon that time. They had the lob coming, and Gordon got a hand on the pass.
If you can get the ball in the middle of any defense, you've always got an opportunity to kick it for shooters.
Errant pass by Patterson. Two on nobody. Anderson Hunt.
Going back to man-to-man. No, they haven't. What they were doing was they were going to play Goodman man-to-man.
Another turnover. Ogwin ahead to Anthony. Race to the basket, no contest.
We're talking about a race or a basketball game.
That's true. Got to play this one in lanes. Goodman for three. Over and off. Gordon tries it. First attempt that I can remember that Gordon's taken tonight. Elmore Smith, three on one. Nice pass by Johnson. He was in traffic, gave it up to Hunt. He missed the shot.
Missed the play, but the outlet pass makes it. I mean, Spencer gets that down better than anybody. That's why he's going to be a valuable piece of what the Rebels are trying to do.
Patterson for three. Four on two. Once again, the Aggies didn't get back. Johnson to the basket. And the Aggies right now are just not getting back. They are not in this game at all.
Well, they got back. They just didn't do a very good job of stopping Larry Johnson.
UNLV has had the numbers the last four times down the floor.
Playing man-to-man on Jake Goodman. He's the three-point shooter, and Anderson Hunt has been guarding him.
Elmore Spencer, the rejection.
Well, Goodman's getting a real lesson here. You cannot go in there amongst the trees and the jumping ability of the Rebels. I mean, I'm not sure where Jake Goodman is going with this ball. You see, Spencer barely gets off his toes to block that.
Well, the last 4 minutes and 38 seconds, UNLV on an 11 to nothing run. Make that 13. Make it 14. That's a charge I don't want to take, I'll tell you that.
But Larry Johnson, the anticipation of the pass, and he's expecting the contact. So he moves away knowing that coming behind him is Jardine. So he's going to take that contact. Kind of give the fans a little something to look at.
And this is getting flat ugly here, I'll tell you that.
Well, they're a sight to behold.
Oh. game is quickly getting to the point that I'm not sure if it belongs on ESPN or the Ha Network. Jardine misses an outside shot. This time they did get back defensively. Anthony.
It made a lot of difference.
Yeah, didn't it?
Got to stop the dribble penetration. You know, again, but for Conn Smith, he's got to be able to keep his team's psyche. You know, you get beat this convincingly by a team like Nevada Las Vegas, it can destroy the morale of some young kids. So that's the challenge for Conn Smith.
George Ackles prepares to come back in the game. That's the other thing, that Tark just has so many weapons. I mean, he gets eight or nine deep, and he's still going to hurt you.
He will, and not only that, he has another player, Melvin Love, who really hadn't learned the system very well, but he's also available to play. So they've got a number of players. Tark plays eight or nine players, and he can play them comfortably in a good rotation and keep the defensive pressure on you.
Ogman has that one. Highest point production of the year for UNLV came against Nevada. Reno, they ran up 131. I'm not sure they can get to that tonight, but their next highest is 124, and that's possible.
Within the realm of possibility.
Yeah. There's still 10 minutes to go in this game. Youngblood out front. He's got a nice stroke.
He'll be a good player, and I think, as we've talked about throughout the contest, there'll be some help for him next year. Give him a chance to grow some more, mature. He's getting a lesson here, and unfortunately, you learn your best lessons when you lose, it seems.
Hunt was there for the follow, just couldn't quite get the shot. The foul reaching in on Ogden. This is a good aggressive foul. I don't think that's a foul any coach is going to berate you for.
Stacey Augman, you don't berate him very often.
That's
he does enough good things for you.
Jardine is short with a jumper, gets it back. Down low to Patterson, a Funk rather, nice move. But at the other end, Youngblood's going to get a call for reaching in. He got the ball, but he got his hand.
Now, Barry, in the ball and the hand, one and the same under those circumstances. You'll see coming down here, you'll see number 32 reach in.
That was pretty close.
Oh, please. Oh, please. You have to understand. That's how I made a living. So I'm going to give the defensive player the benefit of the doubt.
Youngblood in traffic, and Ackles got him.
You know, basically, if you think about long-term view for the Rebels, the one defense that Jerry Tarkanian does not like to play is this amoeba defense. And watching it, you can tell why, because this is not a very aggressive Rebel team. As you can see, George Ackles is fouled out of the game. They don't play this aggressively. They play man-to-man aggressively. They practice it 75% of the time. They practice their defense. So if Jerry Tarkanian had his way, he'd like George Ackles back in the game, but he'd rather be in man-to-man to keep his team aggressive. This is one nice thought, if you will, about Jerry Tarkanian. This is his way of not pouring it on.
Yeah, I don't think Tark does that. He's been winning games by 30 points, but I just think that's a credit to the talent that he has on his team.
I know, there's no question about it. He's really pointing toward the tournament. He's not trying to pour it on anybody, just trying to get as much as he can from his players.
Nice pass. Anthony to Ogman. And Anthony gets the call at the other end. Hey, Greg Anthony's a different player on the floor this year. I've been saying that a couple of times, but Anthony would on occasion in the past couple of years play a little bit out of control, and he'd be woofing at you a lot. And now he's really taken control He's the boss out there. He's the quarterback out there. He's keeping things in control instead of out of control.
It's a senior on his way to getting a job. It's what that is. He understands that that kind of attitude is really not tolerated on the next level. And if he wants to play, then he's got to stay under control.
Nice pass that time from Goodman to the cutter coming across the lane, who was Brent Lofton. Lofton has not even been in that many games so far this year. Just played in 7 games. Utah State's 10th foul, and so now all free throws for Las Vegas, all fouls, I should say, will be 2-shot fouls.
You know, I had somebody ask me, with Utah State playing against UNLV, do you think it's a game worth playing? And as a player, I don't care how good the team is. I want to play them. And granted, Larry Johnson and the Rebels are a very good club. But I think you've got to feel, as a player, that you can beat anybody. You know your chances are slim. But there's something to be said about coming out playing against the number one team in the nation, especially after you get out of college and you're going on and you're sitting around having some Coca-Cola or whatever with your friends telling these stories you're going to tell. You could talk about playing against the Rebels when they were number one.
Absolutely. Absolutely.
And you can talk about your margin.
How close it was.
Of whatever. Victory, defeat. You can be creative.
It's like I love Jack Haley's line playing for the Chicago Bulls when he made his first NBA basket. He scored 2 points in a game, and after the game, the press went over to him and said, how will you remember this game? And he said, I'll remember it as the night Michael Jordan and I combined for 54.
That's the key. That's the optimist. I mean, that's the way you got to look at it, so you can enjoy this.
Anthony Fast hands it out of bounds. We'll take a timeout. 7:41 remaining in this one. 96-59, and the Aggies will be looking for that 30-point shot.
When you visit Arizona Charlie's, you can expect the warmest hospitality, the friendliest service, and the best values in Las Vegas. There's around-the-clock fun for everyone, from sports action you can bet on to cashing your paycheck and instantly winning up to $5,000. When it comes to entertainment, Arizona Charlie's Palace Grand Lounge features the hottest acts in town. Arizona Charlie's, a great place to stay, a great place to play. 740 South Decatur.
Why are a lot of people driving new GMC trucks these days? Mainly because they want a tough truck or van that isn't afraid of a little dirt. But they're also discovering that at Desert GMC, they can have fuel economy, power, and styling starting as low as $86.95. And with 8.9% financing and rebates up to $1,500, now there's only one question left.
What color would you like?
Visit one of the 3 Desert GMC truck dealers. New trucks for today's new lifestyles.
Jordan, Huey, Magic. The inside story on some of the world's greatest athletes is on the NBA Today, Tuesdays on ESPN. St. John's faces Dikembe Mutombo and Georgetown. Then Duke simply wrecked Georgia Tech in an early season clash. Now Kenny Anderson is ready for payback time. Wednesday night, live on ESPN.
So it's the ACC and the Big East on Wednesday. On Thursday, we'll take it to the Big Ten, back to the ACC, and out to the WAC. It'll be Ohio State. Are they a surprise team? Boy, are they playing well. They beat Indiana. The tears are just drying now on Quinn's shirt. North Carolina and Clemson after that. That'll start at 9 o'clock. Clemson, of course, a tough place to play most of the time. Then out in the WAC, all the way to Hawaii. It'll be Wyoming and Hawaii and Hawaii. Of course, pretty tough home team, too, but Wyoming may be the best in the WAC.
Well, they've got some competition with Utah, I have to say. Rick Majerus done a great job there, as well as UTEP with Don Haskins. But Wyoming is definitely a team to watch out for the WAC. I believe they're in second place now. So it's going to be an interesting race there.
96-59 here. Lofton pulls up.
Get up.
Yeah, great job by Larry Johnson to keep that alive. Remember, this game is so far out of hand. Johnson's playing like it's tied. Everett Gray to the basket. Spencer gets the turnover. Goodman gets it back. Funk puts it in. Everett Gray reversed, won't go. Gray on the floor, almost had a gift. Anthony steps in front. This should be interesting. Reverse.
Now you've seen every one of the starters take two-hand dunks. I mean, that's something to behold.
Youngblood knifes in, draws the foul from behind on Spencer.
You talk about highlight films, and you can look, and you can take your choice on who's going to dunk. But this is your point guard with a two-hand behind the back slap.
Substitutions as Dave Rice comes into the ball game, or as they say in the press book, Dave Rice Rhodes Scholar candidate. A routine game for Larry Johnson. 23 points and 12 boards the last time I looked. Not bad.
No, big fella, man. Made some good passes. I mean, you know, they're just not enough superlatives, not in my poor little vocabulary.
Nor mine.
To say all the things this guy can do for your ball club.
If there's a better guy in the country at his position, I really want to see him.
No, I'd take him at that position, period. I'll take my chances that whoever plays against him has got their hands full.
And when I say his position, I mean
anyone
three,
you want to choose.
Or the four, or first base, or left linebacker.
Or tight end.
That's right. I'll take it at any one of them.
Well, he'd be a good project for Bill Parcells and the Giants, I'll tell
Wouldn't
you that.
He, though? What an athlete. 100-62, UNLV over Utah State. It's pretty if you live in Las Vegas. We'll be back.
Tired of waiting on Uncle Sam to send your tax refund? Wait no longer. If you bring in your completed unfiled tax return to Falcone's Tropicana Honda or Falcone's Acura of Las Vegas, in just 72 hours, you'll have your tax refund loan to be used any way you want. Use it as a down payment on a new or used car, and we'll double it up to $3,000. Don't wait for Uncle Sam. Get the money and save now at Falcone's Tropicana Honda or Falcone's Acura of Las Vegas.
The Subaru legacy is much larger than the older Subaru. But people still think we're small and boxy. The Subaru legacy is luxurious. But people still think we're just basic transportation. With 93% registered in the last 10 years, still on the road. We hope our old image wears out a lot faster than our cars do.
Now's the best time to make a great deal on a Subaru and save with factory to dealer incentives.
Wild thing. It is a wild thing. Oh, come shout and sing, join in the ring. It could be queen or it could be king. You go your way and I'll go mine. As long as you just make it fine.
Good times roll with the clean, fresh taste of Bud Light. It won't fill you up, never let you down.
Wild thing.
Well, apologies to Mr. and Mrs. Rice because their son David just made two free throws while we were away and you didn't get to see it. 102-62. Goodman sticks a three.
I'll tell you what is interesting while you're looking at UNLV. You notice H. Waldman isn't in the game? In the Louisville game, H. Waldman was one of the players on the bench that got carried away and tried to make some passes that he really doesn't need to make. And one of the things I'm sure Jerry Tarkanian decided to do is this is an opportunity to show H. Waldman this is what you miss out on when you don't do what I ask you to do.
You saw those numbers in frontline scoring. That's pretty remarkable. Goodman to the basket. He's got a couple of quick ones.
I like the enthusiasm of the fans.
Yeah, it's true. None of them has left. Cheered Goodman. Everett Gray, he's got eight. He'll go to the line. There's Lofton, the guilty party.
you can look at UNLV and they just get deeper and deeper, and now you see a guy that comes in and his primary thought is to score, just taking the ball to the hole. That's on two people.
And he can't score, and he can score in a major hurry. In one game against Reno this year, he played 24 minutes. He had 19 points, 9 boards, 3 assists, and 2 blocks.
He can get it in the hole.
Ruffner with Bice in his face, and Youngblood with Melvin Love in his. Love's another guy who you talked about a little bit earlier who has some real potential.
The tough part for Love is just getting minutes. I mean, I think the difference in Love and Spencer is that Love didn't participate in terms of just viewing practices as actively as Spencer did. Spencer was at every practice, and he looked at them all the time and tried to learn. And I'm not sure Love understood that was part of the commitment he needed to make. But in time, he will be a good player.
Travis Bice fouled on a three-point shot, so he'll shoot three. And he's, you were saying, his hero is Charles Barkley. And you saw how angry he got when he missed that three. He was on himself.
Oh, yes. He's got that kind of temperament. He's a competitor. He's just not exactly what you would call a Charles Barkley lookalike.
No, no. Knocks that one in. He'll have two more. To think guys that look facially look like Travis Bice are inherently tough players. There's a guy who plays at Arizona, Matt Othick, who I've always kidded about looking like Dennis the Menace, and he's got a heart. I mentioned this on the air the other night. He's got a heart like Hulk Hogan.
I can take those guys any day of the week.
Harold Miner at USC is a wonderful player. Another guy with a baby face who plays hard.
Michael Jordan.
Michael Jordan
plays good.
Yeah, he plays all right. But that's not basketball that he plays. There's a lot of guys play basketball. Michael Jordan plays something else.
He's got his own
game. I don't know what that is. I know nobody plays it but him. Youngblood stuck that one. There's Melvin Love, little jump hook inside.
Conn Smith is still coaching, trying to get his team to penetrate, do the little thing.
Nice follow that time by Youngblood. Somebody forgot about him. He's got a bunch. Youngblood with 27. That equals his career high.
Going up.
Everett Gray, reverse, won't go. Right idea, though. Spencer gets it back, slams it, he draws the foul, he'll go to the free throw line. So instead of two, they get three.
I knew Everett was going to shoot it. I wasn't sure of the results, but I knew he was going to shoot it.
Listening to Conn Smith still being a cheerleader out there. Boy, you got to like that.
Coach is never going to quit. I mean, and Conn, trust me, I've known Conn Smith for years. Conn is a competitor, and it's important that he keeps that fire not only in himself but in the rest of his team, because you can't not play hard, because the same problem that can happen to a team like Nevada Las Vegas can happen to a young team like the Aggies.
Spencer leaves and Bobby Joyce comes on, and he's a guy with some talent also. Is that redundant?
Yes, just a tad.
Another turnover. Bice tried to get it ahead to Rice, couldn't do it. Ruffner to Sager.
Sager got a little lucky on that one. He tried to dunk it under the rim.
Everett Gray will take that three and stick it. Gray's in double figures. going to be a foul on Goodman, and Goodman goes down, and he goes down in some pain.
Well, he's got a bad ankle. That's part of the reason he missed games, because he's got a bad ankle, and I think that's what happened.
And he's being very tender on that ankle. Rice might have grabbed that ankle on the way down.
Well, you'll see in the right side of your screen, number 22, it looks like he starts to fall on the ankle. You see right here, here's the contact. You see he fell on the ankle.
Yeah. And that's something that Conn Smith did not need. Conn Smith just came on the bench and just kind of looked up and said, boy.
When it rains, it pours.
That's something he does not need.
No, because that's your leading three-point shooter. Now you lose him in a game that you don't have a good chance to win. But I tell you, we were talking a moment ago about why UNLV is so deep. They play that pro style of offense. And a lot of kids are interested in being professional athletes, professional basketball players. So they will go to schools that they think play the kind of game that the pros are going to come and watch more often than not. So consequently, they come to Nevada, Las Vegas. And unfortunately, a lot of them are sitting on the bench. But at some point, they get to play. And the scouts will get a good chance to see them.
Yeah, in fact, you and I were talking with Gary Colson at Fresno State about that, and he was saying he really doesn't have the players to run up and down the floor this year, but he still has to do it. He's in his first year. He wants to show people, hey, this is the kind of basketball that we're going to play, and if he showcases that, he feels it's going to help him in getting kids to go to Fresno State.
It's the same thing. New Mexico State is doing the exact same thing. I mean, and it's something that is going across the country. These kids want to play, and I don't know if you can blame them for what guys are getting played in the NBA. There's nothing wrong with them wanting to play professional sports. My only little editorial comment, if you want to reach or have the dream to be an NBA star, then catch an education along the way.
Yeah, because what percent goes on and plays in the NBA?
Well, the percentage is really small. It's less than 5%, but even more importantly, you've got to get a job. I don't care what you do, even if it's managing your own portfolio, you've got to be able to do that.
Gary Patterson with a three-point shot. And a turnover the other way. And Utah State's still playing hard, much to their credit. And much to Las Vegas' credit, so are they. Sager, nice job to draw that foul on Love.
And right away, Conn Smith is up congratulating him, telling him good play.
Sager actually has played very well tonight. Just a freshman. Bice the long rebound.
I'd like to thank Pepsi and Fred Meyer for being tonight's game. Thank you very much for your support. Pepsi and Fred Meyer.
Boy, a lot of contact, a lot of elbows down low.
Yeah, but you're talking about Love and Daly. Daly's, trust me, Daly is tough.
And Love up over the top of him.
Well, there's a lot of action going inside, and you'll see right here with the nice turnaround jump shot. Daly misses it, but you see Ruffner has position. Love trying to tip dunk it and just got there too late and got called for the foul.
Matt Barnes coming into the ball game now for the Aggies, replacing Gordon. And Lofton will come back also. The double figures now. Lofton will come on to replace him. Well, Jerry can't be displeased tonight with his reserves. They have kept the margin pretty much where it was. Bice off the right side and off. Gray got it back. Forced it up and in.
Stepped out of bounds.
He did. No basket.
Always staying active are the Rebels. They just horse the ball off the offensive glass. You see every Gray goes up. Tough to see that he went out of bounds. Official right on top of it.
Nice play to Daly. And it was Patterson with the assist. Bice with a good look that time.
Yeah, the look was different. He's standing there just catching the ball as opposed to floating.
And a foul goes on Melvin Love. Count the basket.
In order for them to count the basket, the shot had to be in the air. So Travis Bice had taken the shot. Melvin Love, in his effort to try to get offensive rebound position, fouled Daly. Now, Daly is an interesting character. He's from Alaska. Now, what he does during the offseason, chops down trees. Doesn't play basketball much. He chops down trees. That's why he's got those guns on him.
That's right.
You can see by having those 10 rebounds, that's good by anybody's count.
The difference, though, is that Daly chops down trees and Johnson pulls them down.
Yeah, I guess there's a bit of a difference there.
Everett Gray, why not?
Never saw a shot he didn't like.
He's got a bunch, I'll tell you what. Everett Gray with 15 points.
I saw Larry Johnson jump up and try to pat him a little bit on the back, basically saying, I'm glad you're shooting that on somebody else instead of on me.
That's right. Daly got the rebound back off the first by Barnes. Joyce rejected it out of bounds. 124, the second highest total this year for, equaling the second highest total for UNLV.
The highest total ever in this place, ever by the Aggies actually, was 140 points.
That's,
you know who that was
points
against? UNLV, and they lost. They lost by 2 points.
Talk about good news, bad news.
Oh, geez. Can you believe 140 and you lose?
That has been a posture that we've seen a lot with Tark this year. He's been pretty relaxed. And
yeah, always about this time of the game. Other than
that's
that,
true.
Boy, he's got that towel in his mouth.
Travis Bice tried to go lob. Somebody got a hand on it. Joyce got it back. That got a count? Yes,
yeah,
count that
count
basket. It'll be 126. And that makes it the second highest output offensively for UNLV this year. So assuming we count that basket, which hasn't yet been put up on the scoreboard, we'll call the final score 126-83. For Quinn, I'm Barry, and we'll see you next Monday night.
It makes curves something to look forward to, not just put behind you. It's quick, stylish, and fun. Inside, everything to make you feel good inside. It handles with precision, accelerates with authority, and stops with assurance. But then, who wants to stop? The new scoop from Hyundai. Yes, Hyundai.
Now in here, we can all express our true feelings to management. Jane.
I think you're a little
Unintelligent,
arrogant,
ignorant,
unpleasant, self-centered, and totally incompetent.
Thank you all for sharing that with me.
Want to make your business relationships better? Use the best 1030 delivery in business.
Morning.
That's the nicest thing I've heard all day.
Federal Express. Absolutely, positively the best in the business.
All the way live from my home studio.
It's Ricky and Dee.
With a new kind of steak for a new kind of cowboy.
Take it. Jump. Yippee-yi. Yo. McDonald's has something big cooking.
A grilled steak sandwich with sautéed onions and mushrooms on a sourdough roll.
Yo, man, the steak sauce is death.
Yeah, mighty fine dining.
And mighty filling with McDonald's fries.
But you better giddy on up before the grilled steak sandwich is gone.
Word up.
Always good food.
Always good value.
Driving a Hyundai Excel has never felt better. Maybe that's because after selling their first million cars twice as fast as Honda or Toyota, over 96% of all Hyundais are still on the road. But then with all the extras you can get, you feel good even when you're not on the road. Hyundai. Yes, Hyundai.
Presentation of NCAA basketball, UNLV versus Utah State, is brought to you by the full line of quality cars from Hyundai. Yes, Hyundai. And by Federal Express. Absolutely, positively the best in the business.
Come fly the airline that spans more than half the world. United. Come fly the friendly skies.